What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're here with another unboxing. Yes, we got another loading of Geecrack. We got some new chatterbaits. I really like this brand. And then we got the frogs everyone's chasing. We're gonna review these in the future, but let's dive in this box, take a look, have some fun. Well, guys, we are here with an unboxing, and it's a good one. We've got a couple baits. We might as well start out with this one, or two, or three. We got a couple different colors of this bad boy. Yep, the new Googan, the new Poppin', the Poppin' Frog, the Filthy Frog. Got a couple different colors. Pulling out the gill right here. Let's take a look at this baby. I really actually like their boxing. It's pretty nice. Their packaging is not that cheap. It doesn't really matter for the bait, but I really like the packaging. That's pretty cool. It's a little bit slick, like what they do there. But now we're into this frog. I'm betting a lot of you guys are getting this frog. And gotta be honest with you guys, I had to sling one up already. I got the white one on the custom rod. Been putting it to work. I'll tell you that this thing walks very well, but it's kind of hard. You can see right there, let me push on it. I mean, it's not easy to tell through a video, but this thing is kind of hard. It's not the softest frog. We'll jump into how to fix that in the future, but out of the box, it's just not the softest frog. And I got three of them. Let me pull out. Got the black one here. Let's pull that baby out too. And they're all pretty the same. It's not lure to lure. I'd say, I guess, if I had to say which one was the softest, it'd probably be this black one. But they're kind of a hard frog. Got an EWG hook. You see that right there. And I'm gonna let you guys decide for yourself, but to me, they're kind of pointed in and they're kind of pointed down toward the bait. So I'd probably grab some pliers and pull those up a little bit, but out of the package, they're kind of tucked in, and that's gonna reduce the hookups in my opinion. But I hear a lot of guys are smashing on this frog, so don't be afraid to pick it up. Because it does work. Like I said, it walks very well. It spits some water, not the most water of all popping frogs I have and are out there, but it does spit some water. It's not the worst frog on the market, and it's not that very expensive. So give it a go if you're into these Googan guys. I mean, they're a bunch of good guys. They make a lot of good stuff. Some of their stuff just isn't as good as other stuff. I mean, we got the Vega frog too. We're gonna compare against that. I'm not gonna say it's better, I'm not gonna say it's worse, but I will say that this frog isn't my favorite out of the box. But we still gotta have a lot more time with it, and I'll come back with a little bit more information. And you see under there, it's got a really nice insert to keep the water out. I like that. Not a lot of frogs do that. Sometimes they just use the glue, and that's kind of crap. Legs are pretty soft. I think they do a pretty good job with their colors. I mean, this black is freaking sick, guys. The white is probably the best, though. Let's get a good look at this. Got it hooked up here on 50-pound Power Pro. I really like it. I did trim the legs up a little bit. And it's been pretty nice. It works pretty well in the pads. I'll say that it sinks down a little bit compared to other popping frogs, so it's kind of an all-around. I like, if you're gonna pick up one Googan frog, I'd say pick this one up because you're gonna get the most bang for the buck out of the popping frog. But time will tell if these things bang them. Let me know if you're smashing them on these frogs. Next in the box, I guess we're gonna go straight into it because I already talked about it. Let's talk about this Vega, the Sixth Sense Vega, you know. Got a couple different colors as well, had to be fair. Went 3-3, black, white, gill. And I did that to get the same with this one. Got our gill here. Got our white or shad pattern. This one's gargoyle. This is pretty sick. I think this is called Frogville. It's pretty dope. Got that gargoyle. I really like this shad pattern. I really like that yellow that it puts up right under the chin there. Pretty sleek. And then we got her hooked up. We're on the black. We're already testing these babies out, having some fun. Black is one of my favorite frog colors, guys. It's amazing. Had a couple blow-ups on this. Hadn't connect with any. A couple small little bucks. But not worried. We're gonna be on fish with both of those frogs and see where they land us. All right, let's jump into the components of this baby. So it's definitely a more slender frog, thinner frog, much thinner frog than, say, this Googan boy. Longer than it, too. And then the hook. Let me show you that Googan again. Big EWG boy. And then we got the round bend. Not many frogs have the round bend. The Jacu Gavacho is one of my all-time favorites with the round bend. Very similar to this bait. I'd say it's a little bit bigger, though, a little bit heavier. But I think these hooks are phenomenal. I love a round bend hook on a frog. And they, guys, they're pointed straight up. I love that. That is amazing. I mean, you put a little bit of weight on the front of the frog, you're exposed. You get it back, even more exposed. And if they're just nipping at it, then you got a good chance to get a hook up compared to, say, to this. They nip at the back. You got a little bit of hook exposed. But I'm not knocking it. Still got to give her its chance. But I think this one's going to have a much better hookup ratio. And it's a little bit slender, so they'll be able to get it in their mouth. Smaller fish will, for sure. Legs, just as good as the other ones. I really like them. I am not sure how I'm feeling about these nipples they have on here. Hasn't seemed to do that much damage to the walking. It walks very well. It doesn't do very good in the mats. I'd say this one's more of a mat for you. If you're going to take one popping frog to the mats, take that one. This one wants to roll. But if you start retrieving it rather than walking it, it does come through the pads pretty well. I like that. But not your mat frog. This is definitely going to be outside the cover. Walk that frog around the cover and then slide in there. Push some slop around with this one and catch a couple more. They got a really nice, let's move over to this froggy one. Chartreuse belly, man, it's like exceptional gill pattern. Sixth Sense has got all their patterns. I mean, let's look at this one again. It's got that, I don't know if you see this hexagon. Where is that, a hexagon? Might be, yeah, I think that's hexagon. Hexagon, little shapes in the back. The black's all black, so that's not very fancy. Oh, amazing looking frog. And to be honest, for how small this mouth is to be a popping frog, it pushes a lot of water. Very surprised, just the way it sits in the water, does get a lot of bubble moving back and forth. And then finally they got this gizmo here that they say keeps all the water out. It does a really good job, but water does get in, and then they got a blowhole on the back. Water does get in this frog. Water gets in all frogs, so just squeeze it out and keep moving. All right, let's move on. I don't want to say too much on these frogs. A lot of videos coming for those. Let's move on. Speed her up with the gills. We came back with some more bellows gill, more 3.8s, got another 2.8. let's open up the 2.8 real quick. Boom, man, guys, I've showed you these in other videos. This is a banging bait. Really love this small one on a jig, small little jig trailer. I mean, you can use it like a fluke, throw it on the Ned rig. Drop shot, haven't drop shot it with it yet. It's pretty sick. And then that free rig, that's been pretty good. Not as amazing as I've seen on the internet, but it's a pretty tight rig, so give it a shot. Try that free rig. Look it up. I don't want to sit talking about how to rig things in this video, but it's pretty simple. Just need a drop shot weight, and you're good to go. Man, this thing is tight. Got the ribs. Displaces a ton of water. Not sure what color this one is. It's all in Japanese, some sort of shaddy pattern. Just got the clear on the bottom, a little more gray on the back with the green and blue flakes. It's deadly, guys. It is deadly. Let's move on to this one. Moving up in size, 3.8s. We got Bug Bomb. Yeah, I started out with the bellows gill with it, but I really like it a lot better. Or the bellows stick with it, I should say. Excuse me. Now we're on the bellows gill with Bug Bomb. Wow, this is amazing color, guys. Green pumpkin. I'm gonna say it's true green pumpkin. It's like a green pumpkin gray to like a purple blue flake. It's amazing. Looks really good in the water. It's a little more of a blue hue in the water. than you can see. And then, man, all these baits stank. They use their salt amino acid flavoring. It's amazing. I gotta just keep showing it to you guys. You guys gotta get this into your pans. Give it a go. Throw it weightless. Throw it on a jig trailer. Throw it as a chatterbait trailer, I hear. This is a crazy bait. Packaging's pretty good, but it does stank. So keep them covered up. And they're pretty durable. I really like, let me show you in a big boy. Put that away. Got a little bit more in the candy gill. Man, that's a good color too. Hard to find this one online. Candy gill's dope. Show you in this one. Upsized my sunburned. This is like sunburned gill. It's just like a aqua green with blue flake. Really represents a bluegill nice. I really like it. And then what I was talking about was the head's really thick, so you can get a screw lock in there and really pin this bait so you're not gonna have any problems tearing it up. Only downside I'd say is the tail right here is really thin, so if they nip at it, you're gonna lose it. But what you're gonna do, that's the way it goes with a bait like this. All right, man, this stank is all over. It's all over my hands. Ugh, I can't do it, too much stank. All right, finally, let's move on real quick. One more of the Geecrack, because you gotta see it. Bam, we got the whole family here. We got the big one. We got the medium one. And I put the small one away. No, I didn't, because I knew. Bam, we got all three of them here for you guys. So if you're looking, I hold three of these boys. If you're looking to get in, you can see big size, about palm size. Mid-range one, you can see how much smaller it is than the giant one. And then the more standard one, here's your more finesse version. These two go hand in hand, banging. This is a little bit more restricted to bigger fish. I'm not gonna say a 2-pounder wouldn't grab this or a 1-pounder, but you're definitely gonna upscale your bites and you're gonna limit your bites with this. So if you're looking for bigger fish, just go bigger bait. I mean, that's a simple tip I can give for you. Bigger fish, bigger bait, and then go from there. All right, let's get this stanky one. I wonder why the big one doesn't have the film cover like all the other sizes. That's something to ponder, you know? All right, let's slide in to another bait. All right, let's move on. We'll stick with the Geecrack just because we're here. We only got a couple of these. We upscaled our bag of the sticks, guys. These baits really took me by storm this year, the whole series. I haven't got the craw, it's not out yet, but man, got the muddy gill right here. It is just an amazing stick bait, different style of stick bait, same thing as the gill. You know, if you've seen another unboxing, I've showed this. This is an amazing worm. I really like to Texas rig it, weightless. My Texas rig rod really slings it. I mean, you could wacky rig this, you could Nico rig this. There's a lot of different presentations. A new one I'm experimenting with. Don't tell nobody. Let's play it. I've been checking it out on a chatterbait trailer. Check that out. Got that Picasso trailer, chatterbait with the trailer. Man, this thing has been... You wait. I'm gonna drop some fire videos with bombing on that. Chatterbait trailer, swim jig trailer. Cut it up and use it as a Ned rig. I mean, they have a smaller one too, so don't be afraid to do that instead of cutting your bait. But yeah, bellow stick, that was muddy gill. Got a couple packs in the straight up green pumpkin. It's a really nice looking green pumpkin, guys. I'm really digging it. It's not too dark. I don't like it too dark of a green pumpkin. And then, you know, we finished it off with a little more of that bug bomb, yeah. Talk about it, bug bomb, looking good. This is a sick bait, guys. I love it, you should love it. Got a pile of baits right here. All right, guys, let's wrap it up with one more bait. You already saw it, but you didn't know I got more. Yeah, pulled it right out of the package. Just grab this other one so you can take a peek. This Picasso Shockblade Chatterbait. I really have turned to this instead of that jackhammer in a lot of situations these days, guys. when I'm trying to keep it down a little more, I'll go to this. I really like the blade. It's got this porting in it. It's really nice to keep the blade down when you're swimming it shallow. And then it's straight up to the head. There's no split ring in between, so that's good. It's gonna give you a really quick retrieve. Getting that blade going again when you stop, bump logs, or if you're jigging up and down, that's another way to crack some fish on a chatterbait. Has a really good weed guard for the price. This is a sub $10 chatterbait, and I mean, there's kind of three big chatterbaits I've noticed to be the top. There's the jackhammer, of course. We've got the midget cricket or the thunder cricket. A lot of guys like that. I haven't had much time with that. I think it's overpriced. I'd rather just step it up into the jackhammer. And then there's this Picasso that steps in here, and everyone just kind of yawns at it. But I'm slinging this thing, guys. I like the head shape. It's really gonna come through the cover well. That face just looks like a fish. It looks good. Kind of got a little bit of flaring. The skirting is good. The hooks aren't that giant. This is a 3/8 ounce. Does it say? I don't think it comes. This looks like a 3/0 or a 2/0 hook. 3/0, I would say. But you can get this thing all the way from 1/4 ounce to 2 ounces. I saw that the blade gets like that freaking big, but you can get up there. Now, the only drawback, and everyone's gonna be complaining, I was complaining, it's got a banded skirt, that's why it's sub 10. Yeah, she's not hand tied, but it hasn't been a problem yet. It's not a problem with most chatterbaits when you're fishing them, but the longevity on them. If you want to keep a chatterbait for a long time, months at a time, years at a time, I mean, banded skirts are not the way to go just because they simply dry out. And then you got to fix it, and a lot of times you don't. You just buy another bait. So banded skirts kind of suck. But guys, I'm throwing this. We got her in that red craw. Everyone loves that fire craw look. Fall's a-coming. I feel a little breeze between my cheeks here. And we're going to be smashing. Got a couple other baits coming in to go with it. I'm excited, guys. I'm excited. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. There was a lot of stuff here, a lot of frogs. So I wanted to go with those first. You guys know, got the Sixth Sense and then that new Googan boy. Gonna put them to the test, recommend what I think is the better of the two. Or are they both gonna be good for your arsenal? We'll see. And then we got some chatterbaits and a lot of different plastics, guys. I love these plastics. If you like this video, guys, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. The trees are dropping leaves on me, so that means it's the ultimate time to subscribe, because fall is here, and you know, big baits are on the way. Hope you guys have a good one. I'll catch you in the next video.